भाषण के लिए फाउंडेशन के निदेशक डॉक्टर अनिर्बान गांगुली जी से अनुरोध करता हूँ।
मैं स्वागत भाषण नहीं दूंगा, इंट्रोडक्टरी रिमार्क्स। और आज जो महानुभाव यहाँ बैठे हैं इनके सामने मैं, मुझे थोड़ा संकोच हो रहा है हिंदी में, इनके उपस्थिति में हिंदी में बोलना, ये मेरे लिए थोड़ा कठिन मैं अनुभव कर रहा हूँ। हालांकि मेरा हिंदी, मैं हर बार बोलता हूँ कि ममता बैनर्जी से बेहतर है, इसलिए मैं अगर हिंदी में बोलता हूँ आप लोगों को समझ में आ जाएगा। पर अनुमति मैं चाहता हूँ कि मैं निश्चित I want to actually start by a few observations. At the onset, I really want to thank all our very three dynamic panelists for having consented to be here today, because it's a very busy day today. Being 21st October, the elections, the exit polls, but they have found time. Harshvardhan ji also has to leave. In this very hall, standing in this very podium, in January 2014, we had organized in this very hall, it was overflowing all around. These doors had to be opened, those doors had to be opened, the entire corridor was blocked. We organized a discussion on the abrogation of Article 370. In December 2013, at that time, Chief Minister of Gujarat and the candidate for Prime Ministership, Sri Narendra Modi, in a mammoth public meeting in Jammu, had called for a debate on abrogation of Article 370. And within a week, we had organized that program. And late Sri Arun Jaitley stood in this very place, at this podium. And I think he gave one of the best analysis of why and how Article 370 could be abrogated. So therefore, we have come a full circle in a sense in the last 6 years. And some of them are with us and some of them are not there with us today. The second observation is, today is 21st October, the founding day of genocide. And this is the first 21st October after the founding of Janasangh when Article 370 does not exist. And therefore, we decided, we focused in on this day, October 21st, to come together and know from those who have visited the region not so long ago on the actual situation on the ground there. I think true narrative is the only way to counter fake narratives.
Saal aur bata dijiye, October 21, which year?
Kya?
The year in which?
1951, year? I said.
51.
Yeah. Or tomorrow is October 22nd, and it was on October 22nd, 1947, that Jinnah's tribal raiders entered and attacked Jammu and Kashmir. And what they did, it is very interesting that a very senior ambassador, Tilak Devashar, an expert on Pakistan, has written today that it is necessary for all of us to commemorate October 22nd as Black Day, as far as Jammu and Kashmir is concerned. And it is necessary to remind the people of Kashmir, especially what the tribal raiders did to them, regardless of which religion they belong to. So I think, you know, that is why we came around to this view, and we thought that we would invite them to come and share their perspectives. One last point I want to make, and that is that if you look at, in 2016, the present Home Minister, at that time only the BJP president, had once told me in 2016 that आपको एक study करना चाहिए कि श्यामा प्रसाद मुखर्जी और नरेंद्र मोदी, श्यामा प्रसाद मुखर्जी से नरेंद्र मोदी तक जनसंघ और भाजपा का कश्मीर के प्रति नीति जो है ये बदला नहीं है। तब मुझे लगा कि मैं करूंगा, ठीक है, अच्छा सुझाव है, करना चाहिए रिसर्च, इसको थोड़ा एक डॉक्यूमेंट के हिसाब से बनाना चाहिए। एंड देन व्हेन दैट आर्ग्यूमेंट वाज गिवन दैट वी हैव कंसिस्टेंटली कॉल्ड फॉर द एब्रोगेशन ऑफ 370 एंड दिस कॉल हैड नो सांप्रदायिक ये डिमांड नहीं था, इट वॉज अ कॉल, इफ यू I would urge all of you to go through all the manifestos of the Janasangh and the BJP till 2019. And if you see that it was a very, every time the call was made, it was made saying that this is what is required for the growth, prosperity of the people of Jammu and Kashmir. This was required for equal citizenship to be given to them and to free them from discriminatory practices throughout. So in 1951, the Janasangh's manifesto said to end the state of uncertainty about Kashmir's future, it should be integrated with Bharat like all other acceding states and not given any special position. And right down to 2019, the same position is reiterated without a break. We are committed, the 2019 vision document says, we are committed to overcome all obstacles that come in the way of development and provide adequate financial resources to all regions of the state. We reiterate our position since the time of the Janasangh to the abrogation of Article 370. We are committed to annulling Article 35A of the Constitution of India as the provision is discriminatory against non-permanent residents and women of Jammu and Kashmir. We believe that Article 35A is an obstacle in the development of the state. 35A, of course, came later. So this is the submission I wanted to make. And we have not come to listen to me, but it just falls on my official duty to make some introductory remarks. We have all come to listen to them and to try and understand what the situation was on the ground is through what they have seen. So I welcome you all again, and I think we should now go ahead with the program. Thank you so much.